As a lifelong reader of National Geographic, I have been exposed to the world. As an artist with today's technology, I have been exposed to people from all over the world. With this special issue, National Geographic has chosen to make us more involved in the world. I'll be jumping into this issue in an art way. I have chosen to use topics from certain pages and make my own issue. Sometimes I will use National Geographic's layout format. Sometimes I will use the title from a chosen page. Sometimes I will use an image from a chosen page. In no way am I affiliated with National Geographic, and in no way is it my intention to deface National Geographic. This is a fun art project. Please play along. Use the hashtag #AprilNatGeoArt, all one word, as your posts. Thanks and enjoy. Me, Beth. And my Instagram is at 4x8paperstuff if you want to see a close-up. So let's get going. Good morning. I'm going to talk for a few minutes. I'm doing this at really slow speed because all the rest of the work, I want you to hear what I'm listening to while I'm painting outside. There's a red tinge to everything because I'm under a red umbrella outside on my deck. I'm doing biddy biddy. I don't know if that's how you say it. Bidey bidey biddy biddy. It's a refugee camp south of Sudan, and there's 250,000 people there. I don't know if it's still operating. It was, or in working. Anyhow, I don't know if it's still there. But they have become a city. They have first aid stations, water stations, schools, churches. They are making another group of people that are making the best out of a really bad situation. And I kind of took inspiration from them and some of the bright colors that I have seen on the last couple pages in this issue of National Geographic. And then the paper started talking, and I went a whole different direction. Geotags, color, letters, and nature. That's what's happening here. So, there's no more talking from me. Nature's going to do the rest of the talking. See you tomorrow. Thanks for watching. Bye.